On we are going to implement the most simple controller one may think of, a P-type controller. P stands for proportional. It's simply going to multiply the error by some number to produce the input for the break. To be more concrete, let's multiply the error with 100,000 meters per second squared. When doing so, we can of course get huge positive and negative numbers that do not make any sense to control the break. So we have to clamp the output. Whenever the result of that multiplication is negative, we return zero instead. Whenever the result of that multiplication is larger than 200 meters per second squared, we return 200 meters per second squared. Why could that possibly work? Assume that when we're feeding this control value of 130 meters per second squared into the brake, we are actually ending up with a wheel slip of 0.1987. Then the difference between the optimum value and the actual value is 0.0013. The controller is going to return the same number again, 130 meters per second squared. So this would constitute an equilibrium. One thing to note about this naive version of the P-type controller is that the value of the equilibrium is always slightly less than the optimum. If anything changes concerning the dynamics of the car or the road conditions, this actual value may change. When the actual wheel slip goes up a little, the difference is going to decrease. We are subtracting the actual wheel slip. This is going to become 0.00129. The error gets a little smaller. Now we're multiplying this error by 100,000 meters per second squared, which results in 129 meters per second squared. We are braking less. And as we are braking less, hopefully, the slip is going to decrease again. So this looks like a stable equilibrium, at least from the one side. But obviously this also works when the actual wheel slip is a little too low. Now implement this in Python. Your first job is to implement the P control as a function. The function receives the actual value and the target value, 0.2 that is, and returns the output of the P control, which eventually controls the brake. Your second job is to call that function to control the brake.